end of summer in Toronto. The CNE is on, probably one of the more family-oriented events taking place all year. But this season, something has changed. An element of the underground is bubbling up into the mainstream. Graffiti, art, or vandalism?
I came to bring the pain, hardcore from the brain. Let's go inside my astral plane. Find out my mental, based on instrumental records. Hey, so I can write monumental.
Technically, graffiti means graffito. It's like it's derived from the Italian word.
Which and means?
Graffito means scrawling on a wall.
So yo, grab a can and put your man up and stand up. For the fresh, never stale, is off the third rail.
And then you've got pieces, which is something like this, which is actually a piece. That's why, you see, we don't incorporate the word graffiti, nothing like that. It's like, it's a piece, a masterpiece.
I like all mediums, anything that's visual, and this is so expressive, it's really exciting. Yeah. It's all very funny. If you really read the graffiti, a lot of it is very humorous, and then a lot of it is very political and very important messages, and some of it's just talking back and forth to various graffiti artists, you know?
What about the fact that most graffiti artists don't really own the canvas that they're painting on?
In the city?
Yeah.
Okay, and look at Capitol Sony Records. They put up posters all over the city. That's vandalism. You take a poster and they're like using wheat paste and rubber and rabbit glue, and yeah, they're putting it up, you know, all around the city. I mean, sometimes they can buy, they've got the power and the money to buy billboards, but then again, they do street promotions, man.
Yeah.
They've got street promotions and they hand out flyers and they litter, you know, all over the ground, and it's the same thing.
Yo, what's up? Kicking it live. The Scarborough King. I be 303.
Can you feel the vibe that rides the slide?
Graffiti can be art or vandalism. This is art. And there are those who don't have self-esteem and they go around tagging their city all over the city, tagging their name, you know, and then to them it's vandalism, right? Graffiti's gone very beyond from what it started out to be as a medium of fame and a medium of vandalism. Now it's a medium of art.
In Chicago, you've got a lot of gang graffiti, technically gang graffiti.
Yeah.
And I cover my work up with that. And, you know, I think I'm doing something more and more beautiful than what they would have on there. It's the same thing as, like, you know, people putting up a poster and I'm just going up and writing my name, man.
I always wonder when I will be the number one.
Yeah. This is somebody like captured in television,
yeah,
and his brains are gonna be blown out. Because he's just basically just like, they're so like, you know, they're so into watching Jenny Jones and like OJ all day.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
they're like in a trance. It's basically man makes machine, machine kills man.
Then there's my beast, Duro the Third. The third, because I'm the third in the world. There's one in France and there's one in New York. And I'm the third dimension. And plus I'm Duro 3, see, because it's all 3D, it sticks out. That's a hip hopper. And Red, he's like, he's, you know, knuckling up. He's ready to fight toys. A toy is like an inexperienced writer. A guy who's really whack and who just goes around and tags and stuff, who can't do stuff like this, who incapable, and they get jealous and they tag it.
Think I use my stick, but you gotta think I got my props hops, cause my tags don't shrink. I'm tagging and bagging, cause my name is famous in the street, cause they know my name's from cruising in the Jeeps.
At what point then do you reconcile street credibility and a street vibe with making money, with sheer commercialism?
You mean not selling out, basically?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, everybody sells out at one point.
If you do graffiti just for money, then you're not a graffiti artist. If you do graffiti and then all of a sudden someone wants to pay you for, you know, your talent, then that's fine. I mean, you're making a living, you know what I'm saying?
I think really if you believe in your heart and you believe in yourself, that's all that matters.